Hi, and welcome to another episode of Average Previews. This game is called Dead Cells, and it is developed and published by Motion Twins. The game is still in early access, but already looks amazing. They describe it as a Roguevania game. Basically, it's a Metroidvania, but with a roguelite style to it. The hand designed the game takes place in a hand interconnected world. A big world. So I have played only a few minutes, and I thought that I'm ready to show you. Frost-related sudden loss for damn longer. Nice. So I can teleport there. Tickle. Yep. Does it do something? Nah, I can just tickle it, because why not? Actually, can I use it somehow? Nope. Okay, let's go. The art style looks great. I like the art style a lot. Okay, I saw something. What's this? Choose one of your three stats to improve. Nice. Weapon damage. That's a golden door. 1000 gold. For more health, sure. Increase health. Nice. Let's go. I really shouldn't destroy the doors, but hey. You can just open them. Causes bleeding damage. Whoa! So they can do that. Interesting. But the game is still in early access, so if you see any bugs, that's why. That's fine. What is this? Blood sword. Blueprint. Nice. And there was something else above. Causes bleeding. Oh, I have to. I'll go with the shield for now. I can block attacks like that. But let's get this guy. And we can tickle this guy. How do I get in there? I wonder. No idea at the moment. So that's how I got the in there. But there's really no opening for this room. Doesn't seem like it. Oh, there is. I can't get there. Oh wait. Let me check. There's something. No. Oh, I can summon. Oh, wrong. I blocked the in the wrong direction there by accident. Hey, teleporter. The promenade of the condemned. Leave. Let's go down. Hello. The stuff is too good for you, scram. Aww. Let's leave. Let's see what happens. Hello. You again. Interesting. I am the collector and I'm about the closest thing you to company you will get down here. In exchange for the cells you pillage from your foes, I can provide you with a few useful items. If you uncover any blueprints, I may be able to provide you with some more experimental items. I do have a blueprint right here. Condition not met. Unlock healing potion 1. Aww. You now own a health flask you can use at any time. Permanent improvement unlocked healing potion 1, you now own a healing flask. Oh, so you put those cells in and that's how you get. Conserve 25% of your gold when you die. This is the permanent progression. I like roguelites. Well, the permadeath aspect is interesting, but at the same time it is nice to me that you can get basically more powerful over time. You can get stronger and stronger over time, which is always nice. Everything you buy here is yours forever. Not even death can take it from you. Simply put, if you want more power, then bring me more cells. Now, prisoner, out of my sight. Your presence grows tiring. Okay. If you're still carrying cells... Oh. I have to put all in. Health potion 2, your health flask. Now has 2 charges. Gold recovery 25%. Random starter bow or starter shield. What would I like? Grenade. I prefer passives, to be honest. Let's go with this, and let's start using it. Use interact. Health restored. And now we go back into the world. Slash roll. Love the serenity. Oh, I can go into the water, yay! Nice. Now... Okay. Ow. Whoa. Nice. Stand here. What is this? Plus one strength. Yay. So these are opponents who don't get stunned from me just hitting them. Why doesn't the you have to time the shield perfectly. Oops. Need to heal. Whoa. Stun you. Oh god. You need to specifically know exactly when they will. You have to learn the animations in this game, that's nice. I keep missing them. But that's interesting to know. 7 minutes and 51 seconds ago. Aww. Tickle, tickle. That probably does something, but I don't know. I don't know yet what exactly. I couldn't. Sometimes the shield doesn't seem to work at all. Like when I push the button, it doesn't come up, but that's fine. And this is basically what happens when you die, you start over. Back already? Well, it doesn't seem to be going all that well for you. Have you noticed how everything seems a little different each time? One could think the island is alive. I wonder if... What do you make of all this? I guess I could try out this for this playthrough. Safety health. Yep, this is completely different. That's cool. So it has some a generation in there, meaning which is an important part of roguelikes. But the levels themselves or the tiles are handcrafted. Which is a really good compromise. Since complete randomness isn't always that great. Well, they're too good for me, yeah. Oh, there's a shield I had before. I still think the shields are better. But I guess it depends on the playstyle. What is this? Inflicts a critical blow on the third consecutive hit. What can this do? Sometimes kills people. Or kills things. Sometimes. What does mine say? Two knives for the price of one. More violence for your dollar. Whoa. Awesome. Let's see. Let's test it in action. Oh, actually I can go up. Maybe. Scroll of power. Let's go with health this time. Basically what this game offers is... What are these? What this game offers is that you feel powerful from the very beginning. You don't ever feel not powerful. Oh, those guys are my friends. Interesting. A swarm of biters crawls from your victims. That sounds awesome. Yeah, and what I was saying that this game never makes it look like you are... or feel like you are... You need progression. You're always powerful. Stuns victims that are more than 75% health. What is this? Whoa. Jeez, this thing is insane. Inflicts 20 damage and stuns nearby enemies. Plus 1 health. And we found this. So let's give away our 14. So now I keep 25% of my gold. In case I die. That's good. I think I should invest into this eventually. This is 40% gold. Balanced weapon, blood sword. Twin daggers. If I had twin daggers, I would gladly put this. But I think I need to... Oops. I think I need to invest into this. Because my starter weapon is currently always a blade. And I think it's a balanced blade. So that's plus 5% damage. Nice. Now let's start investing into health potion 2. That could be really useful. And remember, this game is in early access. I don't know if you can see it too. I don't know if you can see it from the video, but... So this guy charges. Come here. There you go. Whoa. I accidentally hit that thing. What is this? Spartan sandals. Blueprint. plus one strength. And this is also closed down there. 1.5 minutes ago. Nice. That's 3 orbs. So far. Nope. I guess let's go downstairs. Oh, this is this place. Whew. I did not see that. Never rush. Yay, second chest in one playthrough. Automatically targets the closest enemy. 100% damage on a burning target. Let's go with this. Whoa. Let's give this a spin. Oh! Almost fell to my death there. And teleporters you can use like that. Pretty much. Okay, that whip is a bit powerful, maybe. Oh no! Well, actually, yeah. Health is nice. I take it that whip is good against the flying guys. What is that thing over there? That's an elite. Boom! Damage taken reduced by 10%. Collect cells and gold without needing to be in range. You may only equip one amulet at a time, but their effects are powerful. A fine object! I troidly eaten under your clothes to make less work for the artists. Yeah. Oh, and my other one is Prisoner Scholar. Nothing worth mentioning, except maybe a vague whiff of dead rat. Yep, the whip is extremely good against these guys. Tickle, tickle, tickle. Let's enter. I should heal. I did it. This rune permanently gives you the ability to grow climbable vines. Nice. Tickle, tickle. Oh! Now I know what they do. I knew they do something. That is cool. This is amazing. And now we can go up. Now we can go up everywhere. Yeah, the whip is a bit powerful. I rolled at the wrong time, so I got hit. That was awful. I need to get to the next. I need to get to the next checkpoint, or the next... to the next... of the safe areas. Because I have so many orbs. 29 orbs. Don't want to die now. That's the next teleporter. What's down here? Another teleporter. Old sewers. Oh, these are the old sewers and now I can leave. No, now I'm in the old sewers. Ow. That hurt. Well, 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 you're back. What is this? Oh, so you can find these. Spartan Sandals kicks victims backwards and interrupts their attacks. Give me that. Yeah, I think I will put the points into this. Recover 1% of your life with each melee attack and but take 1.5 times damage. Oh, I have to choose. This is overpowered, but this is also nice. I have to take this. That is a really long floor. Oh, I could have used that. Well, that crashed into the ground anyway, so it doesn't matter. Who needs an Italian plumber? Whoa. Sewers are dangerous. I read slow, but you seem to understand what I'm saying. I lost the my rune. So you see, I'm a little stuck. And I need my rune, you see. You wouldn't mind finding it for me now, would you? Sure. Oh, thank you. It's somewhere around here in these sewers. On your side of these bars. Bring it to me now. Who is that guy? Whoa. So those were... Oh well. And I think I have shown you more than enough of Dead Cells for now. And now you get this. Some of the gold from your previous life. Nice. And that's how you progress. You get more and more powerful over time. And eventually you might as well beat the game. I don't know how many levels the game has, or will have when it releases, but... But it, so far so good. Seems a lot of fun. Especially with the controller. I haven't tried it with the keyboard. But I don't think these games are too bad with the... What? This is a strange place. This is going to be very pretty when it's done. Indeed. It's your doing, isn't it? Ah, yes. Of course you're working on it. Like all the rest, I guess. So these are all the weapons I have so far, or all the items I have so far collected. That's how many items there are in the game, I believe, I think. And each of them does something. Can I get them? No. Okay, but yeah. I will definitely make another video when it progresses in early access. The game so far looks pretty. In a dark way. I like the art. The animations are nice. The combat feels awesome. So it definitely has potential. I'll see you in next time. Maybe in this game even. Who knows? And bye.